Live from the Civic Media World Headquarters in Madison, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Albaugh Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Albaugh.
Across Wisconsin on the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming worldwide on the Civic Media app. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Todd Albaugh, live on location, as you can see on the stream via video here on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. We are live in Green Bay, Wisconsin, downtown, the home of WGBW, the talk of Green Bay. It's great to be along with you on a Tuesday. Our producer and engineer, Mr. Aaron Zommer, is back at the world headquarters, high atop State Street, a block off the Capitol Square in Madison. Mr. Zommer, good Tuesday afternoon.
Good Tuesday afternoon to you as well, Todd.
Yeah, I love visiting Green Bay here at our studios because they have their own cool coffee mug. Let me see if I can hold that up to the camera there.
Yeah.
So they have the WGBW logo on one side. Mino and the mayor, by the way, if you have not listened to the great morning team up here, Mino and the mayor, do yourself a favor if you don't live in Green Bay. If you do, you can listen at 97.9 FM, 97.9 FM in Green Bay. Also, WISS. Oshkosh Air Support. If you can't get those two signals over the air, well, no worries. Just download the Civic Media app and go to WGBW, and you can listen to Mino and the Mayor every morning from 6 until 8, every morning from Monday through Friday. It's
and
a great program.
If you're not awake from 6 to 8, but you still want to hear what they have to say, you can always listen to it as a podcast anywhere where you get podcasts or at civicmedia.us.
Absolutely. So, we took a little time off yesterday to help out with some family matters and everything going well. And so I made my way from Shawano over to Green Bay here this morning. And here's what's on my mind. And, well, maybe we should save this because, by the way, here's what's coming up on the show. At the bottom of the hour, Tuesday Tangents with our friend Luke Mathers. So that'll be fantastic. Luke will be in, talk a little news and whatever else is on his mind. We have a brand new What's Worse. And it involves turf and the NFL, because we're in, you know, Green Bay. Got to talk a little NFL. And then on the second hour, at the bottom of the hour, 1:30, Pete Swaba, the wonderful Pete Swaba. He is the host of Nightlight across the Civic Media Radio Network every evening from 8 until 10. And he originates that show from right here in downtown Green Bay. So Pete Swaba will be along in hour number two. I don't know. We'll see if this grinds Lukester's gears or not. But here's what I want to talk about to kick off the big show. I did not have time to eat a lot of breakfast this morning. A little coffee, a little bakery. But I thought, you know, I should get something in me before I go on the air here. Because, by the way, we're doing our 2 hours. And then we are filling in for Matt Flynn on the first hour of Matt Flynn Direct. More on that later. But anyway, I thought, well, you know, I don't do McDonald's often. But the one thing I love is the old bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit. I also like to have a little orange juice with that meal, and I knew I was going to get coffee here at the station. So I didn't really need coffee, you know. You can get the bacon, egg, and cheese meal, which is a biscuit, a hash brown, and or what passes for one, and an orange juice. And so I pull up to the window, and the lovely, I'm sure she's a very lovely young woman. And I say, well, look, can I get a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit, please? And I said, a small orange juice. And she said, do you want the meal with that? And I said, well, is it less expensive if I get the meal? Because, you know, sometimes that's, even though you don't want all that food, it's actually less expensive to get the meal. So I say to her, well, is it less expensive if I just do the meal? And it was like officiating a wrestling match waiting for the pin. It was a three count. I said, is it cheaper if it's the meal? One, two, three. And then I get, I just asked you if you want the meal.
Maybe it was too early in the morning for them.
It was 2 hours ago. So,
and
no offense to her, mind you. No offense to her. But, I mean, look, I've worked retail. I've worked restaurants. If you don't know, that's fine. But just hit, you know, bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit meal, and you see a price come up on your screen, and then you could go bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit, and and orange juice, and you could figure it out pretty. You don't have to use a calculator, or certainly not your head. I couldn't do it in my head. But when I asked her if it was cheaper for the meal, I got back after a long, thoughtful pause. I'm just asking if you want the meal. So that's the way that they started here.
So Todd's having
By the way, it was like $8.25 for a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit at McDonald's and an orange juice, which seems, I think the meal is like seven something. So if you've learned nothing else on today's show, do yourself a favor. Always go for the breakfast meal deal at McDonald's.
Man, what a world we live in. Also, McDonald's prices are so much higher than they used to be. I know everything is,
but that's one thing that
I remember being a kid and talking about that and then seeing the prices now. And if I tell my parents that, my dad's like, yeah, back in the day, it was like 85 cents.
Right? 85 cents. Everything was 85 cents. Well, here's what 25 cents and a cup of coffee will buy you. Nothing, which is exactly what we got out in Washington, D.C., and that's where I want to lead off the show today after our little McDonald's story there. Here's what's going on. We've been off, of course. Yesterday was pre-recorded. That was fine. Over the weekend, lots of things happening, and yesterday as well. And regular listeners of this show understand I am a former Republican. Was part of the Republican Party for 30 years, worked for people, a state senator, here in Wisconsin, worked for a United States Congress member out in D.C. for Wisconsin. I left the party in 2011 over voter suppression issues. So I've not voted Republican since. I can tell you that. But neither have I joined the Democratic Party. I'm an independent guy, more often voting Democratic these days because, like many people, former Republicans, I believe that there's only one major political party in this country that's still advocating truly for democracy. And what we've heard a lot is a lot of bluster on immigration. Immigration is going to be a big issue for the rest of the foreseeable political year here in 2024. And we've heard a lot of bluster from my former party, the Republicans, about we have to fix the border. They've called it a border crisis. Which is an interesting word because I can tell you as someone who worked in Congress for a Republican member in the 90s, there were border issues then. And it's ebbed and flowed over the years. Part of it is the time of year due to weather. During certain times of the year, immigration, no matter who, or migration, no matter who the president is, no matter which party, it always goes up. All right, just a fact. During the pandemic, when the former president, Donald Trump, was in the White House, because of the pandemic and something called Title 42, migration went down, partly because people just weren't moving anywhere in the world as much because of the pandemic and COVID-19, but also because there were emergency measures put in place to keep people on the Mexico side of the border with the U.S. while they waited for processing. The courts found that after the pandemic passed, that was illegal. It was not lawful. So he had to get rid of Title 42, and normal migration patterns ensued. Now, to say that there is not a problem on the border would be disingenuous. Certainly there are large issues, and there are problems, particularly places as in Eagle Pass, Texas, where we have a lot of people coming across the border. And we've talked on this show before about the lack of funding in Congress over the years from both Republicans and Democrats in getting the funding for timely processing of the border. But there's been a lot of bluster for the Republicans about we have to get a border deal done. We have to crack down. We have to get more laws in the books. And the Democrats have agreed to go along, and President Joe Biden as well. In fact, there was a bipartisan effort over the last 2 to 3 weeks here, probably dates back longer. Kristen Sinema, independent senator from Arizona, Lankford from Oklahoma, a Republican, and Murray from, I believe it was Connecticut, you can correct me, Mr. Zombers, a Democrat. See, a Republican, a Democrat, and an independent all working on a bipartisan plan for immigration. And much of it in there is what Republicans have said they want. And now it comes out, they're saying, most of them, not all, are saying, not so much. I want to play you a cut. This is Senator Thune, John Thune, Republican, talking about the border deal before it was released this weekend. Here is Senator Thune, Republican, talking about the border deal before it got released over the weekend.
In the end, get signed.
Is Trump's opposition too much, do you think?
Is what?
Is Trump's opposition too much to overcome?
I don't know the answer to that yet. I think, like I said, in the Senate at least, if the bill is strong enough and good enough, we have a strong number of Republicans that are interested in supporting it, then we'll see where it goes from there. The House is at some point going to have to make a decision, and I assume they're going to be processing a supplemental appropriation bill at some point. Exactly what it looks like remains to be seen, but those are all bridges we'll cross when we get to them.
There was Senator John Thune, Republican from South Dakota. No snowflake. He's a conservative who is trying to be optimistic, supporting the bill. Saying, look, I'm not going to go in and say that Trump's killed this bill. We're going to try to stay positive here. Work in a bipartisan manner, asking people, here's the deal. Trump and Republican MAGA people in Congress started killing the bill before it was released. Now, look, I don't know if they went to a tarot card reader or have a crystal ball. I don't know how they knew what that language was. Oh, wait. The fact is they didn't. They're killing it because they know that progress, particularly bipartisan progress, which Joe Biden is a part of and would sign into law, would make Joe Biden look like the leader that he is. And Donald Trump does not want to give Biden or the Democrats any sort of win. And so he has forbidden MAGA Republicans from voting for this until after the election. We're going to come back, hear from another conservative Republican in the House, Crenshaw. And then we're going to hear what Stuart Stevens says about Crenshaw's comments. Take your calls. And Luke Mathers at the bottom of the hour. Don't go anywhere. We're live on location from Green Bay, Wisconsin. WGBW. It's the Todd Allball Show. Truth, wherever it may lead, and having fun doing it live on location in downtown Green Bay at the studios of WGBW, the Talk of Green Bay, 97.9 FM, 1590 on your AM dial when you come up for Packer football later this year. Wouldn't it be great to get Jordan Love on the show?
That would be awesome. I mean,
he's got to hang out somewhere, right? Have a burger somewhere. We'll track that. We'll get Mino and the mayor on that. We'll see if we can have Jordan Love later on in the year. We are live here on location. Luke Mathers joins us at the bottom of the hour. We also have a NFL-related What's Worse later on in the show. And Pete Swaba, host of Nightlight here on the Civic Media Radio Network every evening from 8 until 10, will join us at the bottom of hour number 2. Glad to have you along with us. Mr. Zomer's on the board taking your phone calls, 844-967-2789, 844-967-2789, talking about what is going on out in Washington, D.C. over the weekend and over the last 48 hours as well, as Republicans who say they want to do something about immigration are now killing a bill which Republicans helped negotiate to help the problem of immigration and the border crisis, particularly in Texas, Arizona, and California. I want to play for you a cut of Representative Crenshaw. He is a former Navy SEAL, conservative Republican from Texas. Here is what Representative Congressman Crenshaw said about what's going on with the political games over immigration.
The
height of stupidity is having a strong opinion on something you know nothing about. I'm extremely disappointed in the very strange maneuvering by many on the right to torpedo a potential border reform bill. If we have a bill that, on net, significantly decreases illegal immigration, and we sabotage that, that is inconsistent with what we told our voters we would do. People will make up whatever reasons they want to. There's a number of them, I'm sure. But it would be a pretty unacceptable dereliction of your duty.
A pretty unacceptable dereliction of your duty. That is conservative Congressman Crenshaw from Texas, a border state, speaking about his own members of his own party. A pretty incredible dereliction of duty not to support this bipartisan measure on immigration. Stuart Stevens, former Republican operative for people like George W. Bush and Mitt Romney. He has been on this program with me and our friend Trigvi Olson. Stuart Stevens, now part of the Lincoln Project. Stuart Stevens was asked yesterday about Congressman Crenshaw's comments. This is what Stuart Stevens had to say about Crenshaw and the Republicans on immigration.
Stuart, he certainly makes it sound pretty simple.
Yeah, but back away from that, and who's Dan Crenshaw supporting for president? Donald Trump.
Right.
Just as Nikki Haley will. That's where, you know, there's something really sad at work here. In a totalitarian society, you have to say things you don't believe because you're afraid of what the repercussions would be. And that's really what's happening inside the Republican Party now. They've created this own little Orwellian world, which is so ironic because if anything defined the Republican Party, it was supposed to be opposing totalitarianism, standing up to the Soviet Union. So how do you square that with the follow-up question, you know, Congressman Crenshaw, why are you supporting Donald Trump? And there's really no good answer to that. And that's where the party is. It's caught between what it says it believes and what it does, and the two are difficult to square.
Stuart Stevens, former longtime Republican operative for people like George W. Bush, Mitt Romney, wrote a great book called The Republican Party, called It Was All a Lie, How the Republican Party Became Donald Trump. It was all a lie. In which he himself takes a lot of the responsibility for what's happening now. Stuart is absolutely right. Well, I certainly appreciate and agree with Representative Dan Crenshaw of Texas, Republican, that not voting for this bipartisan immigration bill, which Republicans helped craft, would be negligence and responsibility. Stewart brings up this great point. The genuflecting to Donald Trump, even though Crenshaw is attacking Trump's position on this, attacking MAGA positions on this, Stewart makes the point. Dan Crenshaw has also endorsed Donald Trump. And I agree with Stuart Stevens. Nikki Haley, when she finally loses the primary, will also ultimately endorse Donald Trump. That is a prediction. Because we can't find too many people, Republicans, who are willing to have the chutzpah to stand up to this guy. Off the text line, WMDX in Madison. You remember you can text us using the Civic Media app. Download it at your Apple or Android device. Mark from the SAC says this, quote, "Too many Republicans in the House and Senate have replaced their fealty to their country and their oaths to the Constitution to Donald Trump, a man adjudicated guilty of sexual assault, among other myriads of crimes that may include treason. And after all, Trump pardoned the treasonous, the judge's expressed opinion during Flynn's trial, General Flynn," unquote. That is the comment from Mark from the SAC. Appreciate that, Mark. Again, you can text in your comments via the Civic Media app by downloading it to your Apple or Android device. Takes less than a minute. It is free. It was what Gail King at CBS calls a deal. Also taking your phone calls, 844-967-2789, 844-967-2789. 877-867-2789. Again, the fact that there has been this spin doctoring by MAGA Republicans, Trump in particular, to put out disinformation, quite frankly. You know, they're latching onto this thing. Oh my gosh, this thing is going to let 5,000 illegals, quote unquote, across the border every day. That is called gaslighting. It's called ginning people up. And a lot of conservative members of Congress have come out and said that is just flat wrong. What the proposed bill does is says once it approaches a daily migration of 5,000 people, the president, vis-a-vis Homeland Security, would be able to essentially say, okay, we're not going to process any more people that day, not going to allow any more people in. Those are the kind of games that are being played with the American public. That is disingenuous. America works best when we work together. You think of Wisconsin, Tommy Thompson, and former Democratic Majority Leader Tim Cullen, who ended up joining Tommy's cabinet. Tommy Thompson, Republican, conservative, who worked with progressive Democrat Bob Jelk, a former majority leader in the Senate himself, to get great things done for northern Wisconsin. There was a time in this state when we could actually work together to achieve results. My former boss, Dale Schultz, Senate Republican majority leader, worked with Democratic leader Judy Robson to help create Wisconsin I. Great Public Affairs Network, the C-SPAN of Wisconsin. We are at our best when we work together, and today's Republican Party does not want it. Back with Luke Mathers on the other side. This is the Todd Bull Show on location. You're listening to us from Green Bay on the Civic Media Radio Network. Live on location from beautiful downtown Green Bay, home of your Green Bay Packers, heard across the Civic Media Radio Network on select stations. And as David Letterman likes to say, let's hope that one of your stations is selected. We are here at WGBW 97.9 FM and AM 1590. You'd think I could remember that. But anyway, it's 1590 here on the AM dial. Glad to be along with you here in Green Bay, back at the world headquarters in beautiful State Street, high atop a block off the Capitol Square. It is time on a Tuesday once again for Tuesday Tangents with Luke Mathers. Lukester, how the heck are you?
Oh, I'm doing great, Todd. Glad to be with you here on a Tuesday. Thrilled to be with you on the airwaves.
Always good. I'm here in beautiful Green Bay.
I'm a little jealous. You're getting out to all of these different Civic Media locations. It's giving me some travel envy.
I've said this before. Whenever you travel around and you meet different people, you find out how much we're actually the same and want the same stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that there are, you know, I think too often, and I've done it on this show and other people I know, you know, you say, oh, well, this part of the state is red or this part of the state is blue. And we try to put these people in boxes, you know, political boxes based on an election or a series of elections. But when you actually talk to people and just listen, I think people want a government, whether it's local, whether it is regional, state, national, that just works. Mm-hmm. And what we got in Washington, D.C. right now, we were talking about this in the last segment, where Republicans have said they want reform on immigration, and now they have it. And these are not, you know, here we have Crenshaw, Dan Crenshaw, a Trump supporter, not a snowflake from Texas, who's on board with this. Senator John Thune, not a snowflake from South Dakota, a Republican who's on board. Langford from Oklahoma, not a snowflake, a Republican who's on board.
Langford, the chief negotiator for this compromise, Todd, once considered the second most conservative member of the U.S. Senate. That's who was leading the negotiations for this compromise, and apparently it is not a good enough compromise for the Senate. But to Lankford's credit, he's been still trying to push it. He's trying to get this across the finish line, and so it's going to be really interesting to see. But the way that I've been thinking about it, Todd, is have you ever heard of an instance where somebody – takes hostages. And when it comes to, and for lack of better terminology, that's essentially what happened for any form of foreign aid to be passed by this House and by this Senate. There were Republican elected officials that said, we are only going to send more additional aid to Ukraine, Israel, Taiwan, if we get compromise, or if we get they didn't even ask for compromise. They just said, we want more border security. They said, give us more border security, or we're not going to send any more foreign aid to assist nations that are fighting off authoritarian regimes in them, or fighting against external forces and need the U.S. support to be able to defend themselves. And so the hostages were taken of, we're not going to give that aid unless you do this. And so the individuals taking the hostages essentially asked for a helicopter. And the hostage negotiators brought a helicopter. And yeah. And I don't think the Republicans in D.C. thought that this border compromise would be something that would be achieved, but it was. And so it's very, very interesting that now that there is a bipartisan agreement to address what is going on at the U.S. southern border, that it is Donald Trump and other extreme Republican elected officials that are going to blow up that deal.
And to your point, news today, we're going to talk about this on our third hour today, starting at 2 o'clock, that there is a city in Ukraine, I'll have it by the third hour here, I don't have the paper in front of me right now, that is set to fall to Russian troops. Be the first time since May of last year that a Ukraine city has fallen to Russia, largely over the lack of proper ammunition. And that's largely due to the fact that Ukrainian aid is being held up in the House of Representatives by MAGA Republicans doing the bidding of Vladimir Putin in Russia, a party that once stood in opposition to what Reagan called the evil empire, now doing the bidding of Vladimir Putin. And if you don't think that these little places a lot of people never heard of, Latvia, Lithuania, are part of NATO. An attack on one is an attack on all. So, you know, if the Republicans want to hold this up because Donald Trump told them to for political gain, wait until your sons and daughters are being killed on the battlefields of Eastern Europe.
It's going to be extremely important over these next couple of weeks to see whether or not this deal can get across the finish line. And it seems like for his own political gain, Donald Trump is totally fine with delaying the resources to address the southern border, delaying the foreign aid to address the support that allies around the world need. And it's just it's weird because you don't normally hear the quiet part out loud to this extent, Tom, mm-hmm. where Donald mm-hmm. Trump is essentially going around and saying, I want credit for this. And I don't really see how that is a smart way to address what's going on right now in the world. But it seems like that's the tactic that in Washington, D.C., there are many individuals that are looking to bow down to a former president who is on the campaign trail again in an effort to help him because they think it's politically expedient. It's terrible to see.
844-967-2789, 844-967-2789. Let's go quickly down to Stoughton in Dane County. CJ in Stoughton. CJ, thanks for calling. Go ahead. CJ, are you there? What say you?
Yeah, thanks for taking my call, Todd. I know you're a former Republican, but here's what it's all about. Speaker Mike Johnson, I watch C-SPAN. Got five TVs watching everything, okay? He was on the floor, showed 64 actions that President Biden took to end what was a success under Trump. The last month of Trump's presidency, there was 30,000 illegals. And Biden campaigned on it, said, come. Well, last month, 302,000. This is a political ploy. He has the tools. He overturned what Trump had. Stay in Mexico and catch and release. He reinstated it. He could overturn this. The president could solve it today. The president is using it as a political issue. So,
all right, well,
you know,
I appreciate the call. I appreciate the call, CJ. I appreciate your viewpoint. But do you disagree with people like Crenshaw, who is a Trump supporter, and Thune, who is a Republican, as Luke just said, Lankford, second most conservative Republican in the U.S. Senate? You know, I'm not in the room, CJ. You're not in the room. Luke isn't in the room. These people are in the room crafting this. And, you know, I'm not going to go down every single point that I disagree with you on. But I guess the question to you as a Republican is, are you saying that you disagree with these most conservative people of the party who are saying the president, doesn't matter whether it's Trump or Biden or whomever, they're saying that the president doesn't have the proper authorities under the law and that this bill would address it for whether it's Trump or whether it's Biden? Do you disagree with what they're saying?
CJ?
Are you there, CJ?
HR 2, the Senate and Schumer shut that down, refused to take it to the floor. But now you want to criticize.
But we're not talking about HR 2, CJ. We're talking about the current bill. The current bill that was crafted by Republicans in large part by Republicans. Are you saying you disagree with them?
I disagree. The president has the power to fix it.
Then what's the need for HR 2? What's the need for HR 2? If the president already has the power, why would the House of Representatives, CJ, need HR 2 to pass for that additional power to be granted to the president?
He was proud that he said, you'll never see another foot of wall. So, you know what? We've got millions of dollars of materials. This is all planned. This is intentional. The president's using it as a political football.
Joe Biden's fault. Right. Okay. CJ.
All right. Thank you, CJ. Thank you. I appreciate that. All right. I want to let all people have a say here. That's fine. You can have an opinion on it, but again, I'm going to trust both Republicans and Democrats and Independents. I mean, how many times, Luke, have we seen Republicans, Independents, and Democrats, all three, be able to come together in a room and craft a bill and say this is a real thing?
Well,
and
during Joe Biden's presidency, we've seen it quite a few times, actually.
Right? Yeah.
Joe Biden's been pretty good at finding bipartisan compromises, and it's interesting for CJ to talk out of, and I think it's important to address some of those aspects because he's talking out of both sides of his mouth. He's saying it is that, and this isn't just CJ. This is some talking points that you see in a lot of different places right now.
This is Fox News and OWN and
Newsmax. All of those, they don't know what to do right now because, as you pointed out, there are leading Republican elected officials that want to see this bipartisan compromise get over the finish line. There are bipartisan efforts to get this aid to Ukraine, to Israel, to Taiwan. There is bipartisan efforts to address the problem at the border. But at the same time, a former president is pushing on other members of his party to not pass this because he wants to campaign on it. So now there are these talking points that are rising. Oh, it's Joe Biden's fault that this compromise isn't getting. Joe Biden would sign this compromise bill if it comes to him. And it's not Joe Biden that is not getting this done right now. It is Donald Trump. And you don't have to take anyone else's word from it other than the former president. Donald Trump is doing the V from Vendetta line saying, tell them it was me. Tell them I'm telling you to not pass this bipartisan deal. And so it is very, very interesting that there is that kind of criticism. At the same time, they're saying, oh, well, Biden could solve this problem. He doesn't need any additional support, but he could solve this problem if he wanted to, but he doesn't want to. Because you can't have it both ways. You can't say that HR 2 was what the second thing the Republicans passed when they took control of the House of Representatives after the midterms, saying we are going to give the president more power over this issue, and then simultaneously say he could act without any of these actions. Like, it doesn't make sense, Todd.
Let me take you back, Luke, to 1948. Even I wasn't born back then. But 1948, the 80th Congress passed 388 public bills, making it hard to call it exactly do nothing. But then the president charged that Republicans in Congress were blocking his quote-unquote fair deal legislation, which would have lowered housing and food costs. At a campaign event in New Jersey, October 1948, President Truman said this. Said, I've been trying to get the Republicans to do something about high prices and housing ever since they came to Washington. They are responsible for that situation because they killed price control and they killed the housing bill. That Republican 80th do-nothing Congress absolutely refused to give any relief whatsoever in either one of these categories. History has repeated itself in 2024. The Republican House is a do-nothing Congress, and Derek Do-Nothing, Derek Van Orten, is largely responsible. Do-nothing Derek. That's my new nickname for him, because he wants to do nothing to actually make things work.
I think that's a pretty good nickname, Todd. You worked hard on that one.
A lot of windshield time. Got to think about something.
Hey, man, yeah, you're getting those miles in traveling across the Civic Media Network.
But the point is, I mean, you said it well, Luke. There are solutions there. And how many times have we heard people call in our audience who has said, look, I'll clean it up for radio, just get stuff done. I don't care what party you come from, just get stuff done.
That's because what Wisconsinites want, and that's what I think a lot of Americans want.
If you're a working person, that's what you have to do. If you're on the job, your supervisor doesn't care what hat you wear, just get stuff done. If you don't get stuff done, you're fired. That's what working class people do every single day across Wisconsin, and it's time the Republicans in the House of Representatives do the same thing.
Yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see. I don't know if this deal is dead in the water yet, but it's going to be interesting, and time will tell of what comes of it, but it's something that we're going to have to keep an eye on, and I think if it does not pass, it's very important to credit the individuals that prevented it from passing correctly.
Do nothing, Derek, grinds my gears. What grinds Luke's on the other side? Don't go anywhere. We're live in Green Bay, the Todd Oliver Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It takes one to know. Welcome back to the Todd Oliver Show, live on location in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Beautiful downtown Green Bay on WGBW here at the Talk of Green Bay. We are on the Civic Media Radio Network. Glad to be here in the Upper Fox Valley for a Tuesday Tangents with Luke Mathers is on tap. Before we go back to Lukester, let's go quickly to the phone lines, 844-967-2789. Karina in beautiful Milwaukee is holding on the line. Karina, thanks for holding. What say you?
Hi, Todd. Sunshine today. Is it the sunshine on your side of the world?
It is. It was very foggy up here in the Fox Valley earlier this morning, but it's kind of burned off, and it's always a beautiful day in Green Bay.
Yes. So, you see, Todd, this is why I hoped that with the maps changing, they will come in Wisconsin to the decision to, and I know it's messy, I know it's a long process, to re-vote or whatever it is, people we had over the past 12 years. And the reason why, because you see, nowadays, they don't use, the Republican Party do not use filibustering or jacking up the budget so they can stop working altogether or have a break, a 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks instead of two or whatever it is. Now they're just blindly saying that they won't do it because there is a Biden as a president, which is a Democrat, and we're going to wait for our Republican president to be there and take all what the Republican president can do. So basically, and you can see with the Trump, with the borders and all other issues, they not only stopping the process, they actually put themselves a whole body on the brake, basically, and do not just don't want to do anything. They are resisting, and they're not allowing things to happen.
Yep. Karina, I really appreciate the call. Thank you so much, Karina, in Milwaukee. Look, I think she brings up a great point, is that, you know, it is all for political gain right now on the Republican House side, especially. In Wisconsin, we're awaiting new maps on the state legislative side from Wisconsin Supreme Court, but there is no lawsuit yet to address the congressional maps in Wisconsin. However, in other states, there are. So perhaps due to redistricting in other states, that could, and I think these coattails, yes or no, agree or disagree, I think these coattails of Trump saying don't do anything for political purposes, I think that will have an effect with, in particular, independent voters this November.
Yeah, I think it's going to have its ramifications. We're getting to a point, Todd, where every other even year, nothing can get done in Washington, D.C. because it's a presidential election. We saw in 2016, the U.S. Senate cannot confirm a Supreme Court justice, not during an election year. We're hearing now that we can't solve the border. It's a very large crisis at the border, but nothing can be solved because it's an election year. Chuck Grassley, the U.S. Senator for Iowa, is floating the idea that a bipartisan tax deal that would return the extended child tax credit and some tax relief for small businesses across the United States. He doesn't know if they can pass it past the House, but that one doesn't know if they're going to pass the Senate because it may look good for the president. And so we can't do tax bills. We can't do immigration reform, and we can't confirm Supreme Court justices. That's the list so far, it seems, that can't be done during presidential election years. And I do worry. Go ahead.
Yeah, and to your point before in the last segment there, that Joe Biden continues to get stuff done. He isn't boisterous. He doesn't go out there too often and say negative stuff. He just gets things done. And there, once again, is the experience of someone who's been in Congress, who knows how to negotiate, who's worked with both sides. And they said the economy was going to tank. And he had, what's his name, Goofball Crudlow from Trump's administration on Fox going, well, I guess I was wrong about that. The bimbo host was like, oh, no, you weren't wrong. You were fine. Oh, no, I was wrong. You had that going on over on Fox. So, they were wrong about Biden on the economy. It's going gangbusters. They were wrong on Biden about jobs, lowest unemployment in forever. Most jobs created in the last five administrations combined. Time after time, they underestimate Joe Biden. And here again, they're doing the same thing.
Yeah, I don't know if the comeback kid is necessarily the best moniker, but it feels like Joe Biden is somebody that gets underestimated time and time again when it comes to politics, and I don't understand why. Because when it takes the work to be put in and get compromise found, because compromise is a dirty word to some politicians these days,
yes.
And you can. Yes. Some people just want to run for office and rail against compromise. I don't think
money off a compromise.
It's not a sexy political fundraising aspect. No. You're right, Todd. And so there
and
is.
And believe me, there's anybody that knows non-sexy, it's me.
Your words. I'll leave that to you, buddy. But the division that can be so often seen in our politics is not a style that the current president takes. And I think that's a breath of fresh air. So underestimate him all you want. But it is very telling that the current president Biden has overseen more bipartisan compromises than I think any administration could tout in modern history.
Always goes too fast with you, Luke. A couple of quick comments from Andrew in Maine from WAUK, the Shaw off the text line. Luke, we also can't support allies during election years. Unquote. Great point from Andrew. And we got all of a minute and a half left. Luke, here's some Steve in Milwaukee on the Shaw says, Putin sympathizers grind my gears, i.e. Russian Ron Johnson. Lukester, it's Tuesday. What grinds your gears?
I got enough political stuff grinding the gears. This one is a little bit more sports tangential. So
Give it to us.
Really grinds my gears that we've got some basketball teams here in the state of Wisconsin that have had a hard time this past week putting away W's with double-digit leads, both the Bucks and the Badgers falling after taking double-digit leads against their opponents over the last couple days. And it's a bummer to see they can't close out those games.
I'm going to tell you this right now. You can take it to the bank, bet your life savings on it. The Badgers will get to at least the Sweet 16 this year.
Oh, there we go. You know what
that's, at least.
That's reminding me now. We've already got to start talking about pools, bracket pools for here at Civic Media.
For those of you listening, keep in mind that Todd is not a financial advisor.
Take it to the bank. Also, you can hear the Badgers across Civic Media on a select station, also on the Civic Media app, particularly via WRCE. And if you live in Southwest Wisconsin, it is Super Bowl Sunday. The Super Bowl is going to be on WRCO FM 100.9, Lukester. Can't wait.
It's going to be a good game. We'll have to talk about some predictions, but maybe I'll have to come join you later in the week to talk more about
that. You will. I'll guarantee that, as we say back in the RC. Luke Mathers, thanks so much.
Take it easy,
Todd. Stay tuned. Hour number two of the All Ball Show, live from Green Bay on the Civic Media Radio.